Hello, Kindersley Alliance Church. This is the video that I promised you dealing with the COVID restrictions and the things that we'll be needing to do this coming week. The first thing I want to tell you is that our service is at 10 o'clock and we are only having the one service. This is actually a return to our roots. We met together at 10 o'clock for many years, I'm told, and we're going back there. So good. That's what we will do. We'll meet at 10 o'clock at the church, a half an hour early. You'll need to sign up to come to church. This is just one of those things that we need to do, and you'll understand why in a minute. When you come to the church, you are going to encounter ushers, and the ushers are going to take you into the sanctuary, and they are going to sit you at a very specific place. You're not free, unfortunately, to choose which chair you are going to sit in, reason being because of social distancing and because of our cap of 30 people attending the service, we just need to be strategic. The good news about it is you are free to move your chairs as far away from groups of people as you want to increase the distance between you and people, but we assure you we've set up the chairs as far as they must be. You're just welcome to do it farther if you would like. There's going to be two areas set up for people to attend the service in. One is in the sanctuary, as I said, and 30 people in that. And the other one is in the lobby. Again, you will not be able to choose where you get to sit. And if you did and you chose the lobby, you would hurt my feelings because I'm not in the lobby, I'm in the sanctuary. I'm kidding, a little bit kidding, but it's interesting. I'll come to church, but I want to sit as far away as I possibly can. Hey, let's get together. But anyway, what we're going to have happen is people who are in large families who have signed up in advance will be sitting out in the lobby. Reason being, we don't have enough room in the lobby for 30 people to socially distance from themselves unless there are large groups in a family unit. So for instance, my family has 5 people in it, and I can sit closely to all 5 of those people. I just cannot sit closely to the people in your family. So we are going to, once you have pre-registered, we will know where people are going to sit, and we will usher you there, and we will have a service together, and we will have communion, and we will have community together. The next thing you'll notice is that either Cheryl or someone from the kids ministry team will be out front receiving your kids and gently moving them to the kids ministry room where social distancing and COVID restrictions are being observed, and there's kids church there. The reason that we're doing this is because, of course, that 30 number, we can't exceed that, and we want to make sure that we can put as many people as possible in there, and we have a tailored service for kids. So there won't be a release of kids in the sanctuary. What else do I need to tell you? There are 2 sitting areas, there's kids church, there's assigned seating, and you'll need to sign up. Youth and Awana are happening, and we didn't think that they would be able to happen, but with new regulations and new clarity on those regulations, they are able to happen, and so that's an exciting thing. These actions that we are taking have fallen nicely within both the letter of the law and the theme of the law as given to us by the government, also as given to us through the Christian and Missionary Alliance denomination, but also are in line with what the other evangelical churches in town are doing. The pastors, we've got together and we've discussed what does this look like in each other's churches. This is basically what it's going to look like in each church. Of course, we assume that, we've said that, but it'll be similar anyway. You are going to need to wear a mask in any public building. This is a public building. There's 2 things I want to leave you with. The first is this. I really want to thank you for those of you who have taken the time to give us notes of encouragement or leave us phone calls, whatever it was. It means the world to me. It means the world to the board. This is a time where change is so rapid, and it's uncomfortable often. Also means that there are complaints that are, we hear a fair bit of them. For those of you who have said thank you and offered encouragement and said you're praying for us, I just want you to know how much that means to us, and thank you for that. The board and myself, we've been meeting together, we've been praying together, listening to God together, discussing what our path forward looks like. And we think that this path forward is a good one. We think this is one that is suitable and is glorifying to God. I also want to tell you that you'll notice that when you're sitting in the sanctuary, that hard and fast 30 number, that does not include the people who are necessary to put on the service. The pastor, the worship team, as they sing, as they play instruments, the tech teams, the ushers, all of those people who are necessary for this church to function, those people are not included in the 30, meaning that we will have a number higher than 30 in that room, but only 30 people who are participating in the worship service, but not necessarily leading in it. So I hope that that's clear. The last thing that I want to tell you escapes me, which is funny because I have shot this video, I think, 4 times now. It's this. We are going to provide for a necessary thing that normally happened naturally. Now there needs to be some structure around it. We are going to enter into a time of Holy Communion, and Holy Community, meaning that there will be opportunity within the service for us to find out how each other are doing, how we can pray for each other, how we can be in each other's lives appropriately. This is important, and it's something that is near and dear to God's heart, and we are including that in our worship service. Instead of it happening just naturally as you pass people in the lobby, it's going to happen with a bit more structure, but I'm excited about it, and I think you'll like what you see. At the end of that will be the benediction, and you will be, you're always free to go, but there will be the official end of the service. Live streaming will be happening on YouTube. Last week was our first kick at the can, and we are still polishing our method, but that'll be happening, as well as the service proper will be edited and posted usually Monday night or early on Tuesday morning. You'll see both of those things. I want to invite you to come. We need you to sign up by Thursday. I'll be posting this tonight. Please watch. Please sign up by Thursday. This is something that's going to be happening on an ongoing basis. We are only having the one service. We're only having the 10 o'clock service because we should have enough space to accommodate everyone and function within the guidelines nicely. I look forward to seeing you this Sunday. I really look forward to it. It's my favorite day all week. Merry Christmas. Come to church. Let's be together. We'll see you on Sunday.